verge of economic collapse. Fast forward to the present day, the West African nation has staged a remarkable comeback and is predicted to be the world's fastest growing economy. Long known as one of the largest cocoa producers, Ghana's growth is now being buoyed by different commodity. Expanding crude production and rising prices have placed Ghana's economy at the top of the GDP growth tables. The International Monetary Fund estimates GDP will rise 8.8% this year, double the pace of emerging economies as a whole, and well ahead of world growth. While Ghana's prosperity is closely tied to the oil markets, it remains one of the largest exporters of gold in the world, and cocoa is also still a significant product. But it's not just Ghana's resources that are driving the economy uptick. Under a stable democracy, government initiatives to formalize the economy and introduce a more favorable taxation structure are starting to bear fruit. On number 10, we have Ghana's solar-powered airports. The government of Ghana has announced plans to implement a project to power the country's airports with solar energy. Ghanaian Minister of Aviation Kweku Ofori Asiama revealed the report and said that the government has sought Indian expertise for the project. Kotoka International Airport in Ghana is likely to be the first to benefit from the solarization project for the country's airports. The authorities intend to build a solar power plant with a capacity of 6 megawatt peak. Kotoka is Ghana's largest airport, serving the capital Accra with a capacity of more than 1 million passengers a year. The Ghanaian Ministry of Aviation estimates the solar power could cut airport electricity bills by up to 30%. Green energy will also reduce the carbon footprint of Ghana's airports. The country has one of Africa's highest rates of access to electricity. Ghana's rich array of renewable energy resources can address energy insecurity and help to expand energy access. These resources include biomass, solar and wind energy, along with hydropower potential. Before we continue with the video, kindly smash the like button to help it spread across the beautiful continent of Africa. Thank you. At number 9, we have Tema Port Expansion. The Tema Port Expansion project will result in a new state-of-the-art container terminal in Tema, Ghana. This will include a new 1.4-kilometer long quay housing, 4 container berths, containing stacking yards, a 4-kilometer rubble mount breakwater, a 19-meter deep port access channel, and various supporting port infrastructure and services. The development will enable the port to accommodate some of the world's biggest container ships and improve cargo handling services and capacity. In so doing, it will treble Tema Port's current annual traffic of about 1 million 20-foot equivalent units. The vision is for the port to become a leading maritime hub in West Africa. It is a joint venture between the Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority and Meridian Port Holdings, with Bolo Transport and Logistics and APM Terminals as the two main shareholders. Number 8. Volkswagen Car Assembly Plant. The President of the Republic of Ghana, Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, has unveiled the first Volkswagen vehicle to be assembled in Ghana, following the establishment of the VW Assembly Plant in the country. President Akufo-Addo expressed his delight at the decision taken by the Volkswagen to assemble a number of its brands right here in Ghana, not only for domestic use, but also for the West African market. According to the West African country president, there were many who expressed doubts about feasibility of such an assembly plant being established in Ghana. And there were those who, for narrow partisan considerations, described this announcement as nothing but a hoax which would never see the light of the day. VW's presence in Ghana has been facilitated by the government's bold move to develop the Ghana Automotive Development Policy. Under the auspices of the Ministry of Trade and Industry, with generous fiscal incentives. At number 7, we have Kumasi International Airport. Construction of a new terminal building and other ancillary works at the Kumasi Airport is nearing completion. In June 2018, President Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo cut the sod for the second phase of the expansion of Kumasi Airport, which is expected to be completed in the next 24 months. The project, valued at about $300 million, comprised the extension of the runway to accommodate Boeing 737-800 series aircraft, construction of a new two-story ultra-modern terminal, construction of additional aprons, restaurants, shopping, and parking areas, and also a ring road around the airport. It is expected that the new terminal will have the capacity to handle 1 million passengers per annum. The expansion project was part of the multimodal transportation system being developed by the government to enhance tourism in the Ashanti region. At number 6, we have Marine Drive Project. The Marine Drive Tourism Investment Project is a 241-acre redevelopment scheme of Accra's waterfront initiated by Ghana's Ministry of Tourism, Arts and Culture. The brief for the project being, the origins of which trace back to the country's independence 60 years ago, called for a scheme that would establish an iconic skyline for Accra and transform the capital city center into a world-class tourism enclave. The Marine Drive will also provide essential infrastructure to support the country's developing cultural and creative industries. The plan introduces a new waterfront promenade that reimagines the coast as a vibrant leisure and recreation space. Number 5. Petronia City. Petronia City is designed around the ideology of work, live, learn, and play. It's a self-sustaining, master-planned, and integrated city. It will attract, retain, and support businesses, human capital needs, and elevate Ghana's western region into a world-class business location, tourist destination, and home. The project will see the development of West Africa's first energy city, the main business hub, and office park for international key players in the oil and gas mining sectors. Located in the center of commercial zone, Energy City will provide the opportunity for industry leaders in oil and gas and mining exploration, production, and related support services to work in close proximity with one another and form a more efficient business and community by taking advantage of shared resources, technology transfer, and enhanced flow of information. Number 4. The Signature Apartments. The Signature Apartments is a proposed 13-floor residential building located opposite the Accra Mall at Tete Kwashe Interchange, Accra, Ghana. According to the developers, the concept is inspired by Ghana's Adinkra symbol Mframadan, which denotes strength and sturdiness. The Signature Apartment is situated 2.7 kilometers from the tallest residential building in Ghana, the Villaggio Vista. The project is being developed by Cape May Properties Limited, which is the real estate arm of the industrial conglomerate. Amenities will include a rooftop swimming pool with a poolside bar and fitness center with a steam room. Others are lawn tennis court, ballet and yoga studio, hair and nail salon.